Hello everyone, in this tutorial I will show you how to work with a loft of curves. Let's create a couple of curve profiles, I'll show on complex shapes. Let's adjust the profile a little to make it more beautiful. Now select the profiles and click Loft. This happens with some profiles, you just need to turn it over and twist it. It seems to me there is not enough grid here, let's add it. For such forms, I think this is normal. In order to make it look smoother, there is a smooth button. Note that you don't have a connected piece here, you will need it when working with planes and open contours, but in this case just close it by clicking on cyclic X. You will need a cyclic Y if you want to close the first and last profile. Now if you want to continue, there are several ways to do this. The first way, you duplicate any of the profiles used and drag to the end. You can rotate and change them by adjusting the curves. Let's say I want to make a circle at the top, I duplicate the first profile and drag it to the end. The second way, you can add a curve to the middle. You can duplicate any curve in edit mode, and it will become a continuation of the curve that you duplicated. You can also change it, delete points or add them. If your grid starts to deteriorate, just add a little bit of it. Let's extend it a bit. When you click on the curve, you have an adjustment of the curve points. You can make a square or polygon very quickly. By selecting several curves, and holding down the Alt key, you will be able to adjust the points on all the selected curves at once. You can create the most complex shapes and adjust them at any time. The third way to add a profile, you can simply transfer any profile to the Loft collection and it will be the last one. Pull the profile out of the collection. If you want to remove the profile, you can do the same. And add it back. Or just create any profile and add it to the collection. The fourth option allows you to embed curves anywhere. Try to insert curves here. We have to make the curve active, after which we need new curves. If you click into the void, then your memorization is reset. Then select the active curve on the loft, and then with Shift 1 by 1 the curves in the correct order. If you select in the outliner, then hold down Ctrl, then press Arrangement. If you notice that everything in your collection is sorted alphabetically, it's inconvenient. If you want the sort to be in the loft order, then check the rename box and select the curves in the correct order and click Arrangement. You can select all the curves and go into edit mode for easier control. If you want to rotate or move an object, then click on the select checkbox, and then when you click on the grid, you can move it. For application, there is an apply button. If you check the delete checkbox, then the curves will be deleted when applied. If you make a duplicate of the grid and apply it, then you will have an object editable by curves. This system works on all my add-ons. You can also use loft with different objects in parallel to loop the first profile with the last one. You have cyclic Y. You can also control the transition between curves. You have smooth ones by default, but you can switch to linear, then you will have more accurate transitions along curves. You have two loft collections and you can work in parallel. You have deleted an object and you have empty collections left. You can click on the trash button and all empty collections will be deleted from you. You can also work by adding modifiers to the grid. For example, if you add an anti-aliasing modifier and set it to 15 iterations, then you can adjust the detail by grid value. In the next tutorial, I will show you another interesting feature. Thank you all for watching. I tried to be detailed. By the add-in, it will improve your life a lot.